their mic and camera. All the participants are requested to be patient with technical glitches. Also, make sure of better connectivity strength at your end. Any doubts and queries should be posted in chat box. Our speaker will make sure of addressing most of the queries. By any chance, if speaker specifies any particular participant to unmute and speak, make sure to introduce yourself by giving your name, college name, and city you belong to. Please do not click on present now or end call icon. I repeat, please do not click on present now or end call icon. Feedback link will be posted on chat box here at the end of the webinar and not on any group. E-certificates will be given based on attendance and is also linked with feedback form. So kindly make sure to fill feedback form. Please do not exit session without filling feedback form. E-certificates will be issued in 3 to 5 working days. Thank you. In few moments, we will begin with the webinar. Once again, good day, honored speaker, coordinators and faculties of other department and my dear students. I, Ms. Kinjal Sheth, assistant professor lecturer, on behalf of principal, Dr. Shrikant Savan, the chief education officer, Dr. Mala Kharkar, and the management, with immense pleasure indeed, welcome you all on this one-day intercollegiate webinar titled Podcasting and Content Marketing, organized by the Department of Bachelor of Arts in Multimedia and Mass Communication of Patkar Vardhi College, an autonomous college affiliated with Mumbai University. A brief about today's speaker, Ms. Filoni Kanani. Ms. Filoni Kanani, a marketing professional with full stack portfolio, which includes business to business and business to consumer marketing, PR, corporate communication, social media and digital marketing, photo shoots, video production and event management. In 8+ years of her career, she had the privilege of working in different geographics with multicultural teams, which has helped her develop a flair for creating and curating marketing campaigns that match different tastes. Some of her work are Channel for Radio Network Dubai, Digital Marketing and Social Media Manager, Credit Vidya, Info Credit Services Private Limited, Mumbai, Communications Lead, Seville and Holdsworth Limited, Mumbai, Business to Business Campaign Specialist, Communication for APMEA Region, Behen Code Podcast, Mumbai Producer and Host. And her key achievements across the span of work include increasing the number of followers on Instagram from 1.5k to 12k in 9 months organically, and rise in Facebook engagement by 300%, creating brand awareness, building brand credibility, created a demo video that led to winning the SBI account for Credit Vidya, working closely with regional channel marketers to develop the right message and digital assets for marketing campaigns, owning the communications, messaging, design of the digital asset and regional website, identifying and proposing the right channels for pushing communications. She got over 1,000 views on multiple episodes and got Ankur, Variko and Mini Mathur on the show within a month of launching the podcast. So on and so forth. So dear participants, please welcome Ms. Filoni Kanani on board. Now I would request our speaker to commence the session.
Hi Kinjal, good morning. Thank you so very much for the lovely introduction. And good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much, firstly, for being here on a Sunday morning. Like you have, the quest for learning is so huge for all of you guys that on a Sunday morning, you could have chosen to, you know, snooze and wake up late, but you're here because you want to know more about podcasting and content marketing. So huge round of applause for all of you guys. And a big shout out to all the teachers of Patkar College who are also attending this webinar. They are actually, you know, for you it's learning, but for them it's work. So, you know, they are working on a Sunday despite of working the whole week. So thank you so much, all you guys. You are amazing. So, wow. And Kinjal, thank you for that lovely, lovely introduction again. If you would, I would want to present. Can I?
Yes, I'm sure.
Thank you. Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it full screen?
Not yet.
Okay, now can you see it in full screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Kinjal. All right. So we are here today to understand more about podcasting and content marketing. And I would have been there in Patkar College physically, but as we all know, we are all locked inside our houses and the pandemic is here. So we are doing it virtually. But I would need my audience to kind of, you know, give me a shout out and say that they are there. So how I'm going to do that is I just figured out that, you know, if we all turn on our videos, there's going to be a lot of bandwidth that's going to be used. And, you know, the result will be that our session will be slower. So let's not do that. Instead, give me a shout out on the chat box. Everybody, just type in hi, good morning, something to, you know, show me that you're here and listening to me. Quickly, very quickly, everyone. Please do not turn on your videos until I specifically ask you to. But just, you know, say hi, hello, hi. I want to, yes, I see you, Bhagyashree, Lipika, Mansi, Meghna. Great. Ujwala, Manali, Runal, Amit. Awesome. I see all you guys. Brilliant. Rajiv, please turn off your video. Okay. So as you can read on the screen, turn on your cameras when I call out your name. Pray that I don't. Grab your diaries and your pens because this is a workshop and have an open mind. That's the most important thing that you need to attend this workshop. So Kinjal did give you, you know, a lovely, lovely introduction about me, but here's how I think about myself. I'm Filoni Kanani, right? I'm the girl with a rhyming name. And I consider myself as a serial failure. Like I have tried so many things in my life and I have failed in almost everything, which I think has led me to finally be where I am. So, you know, let me take you through my journey so that you know me more and then I will learn more about all of you guys. So I was pursuing chartered accountancy. I guess majority of you guys are, you know, BMM, BAF, BMS, and all of those streams. But I was this BCom girl doing CA because, again, BCom is sasta, government aided, and CA is a sasta course. My father wouldn't pay my MBA fees. So I was pursuing chartered accountancy because it was a cheap course and I was a smart girl. I still am. But yeah, so yeah, I was pursuing chartered accountancy and I reached a point where I gave 9 attempts in my CA final and I was like, I can't be doing this. One, I don't like this. Even if I become a chartered accountant, that is not what I want to do in my life. I cannot imagine myself being an accountant or an auditor and doing all the finances. So finally, after giving 9 attempts, I quit chartered accountancy and I took up my first job as a writer in Times Internet, Coupon Dunya. And yeah, then on there has been no looking back. I started this blog and coincidentally, the content head of Times Internet came across my blog. He loved it and he dropped me an email. Would you want to come and interview? And just like that, because of my blog, I got my first marketing job. And then on, I have chosen marketing as a conscious career choice, back to back. At one point, I also had my business. But again, like I said, I am a failure queen and my business failed. So I had to switch back to, you know, getting a job. And again, I take up jobs because I want to save money and I have a purpose. So my purpose was to get my MBA degree and I knew I had nobody to pay my fees. Only I had to do that. So I pursued my executive education and I was like, yeah, this March, from MMS, I completed my MBA in marketing after working for 8 years and saving up all the money. I thought that, awesome, March, May, exam khatam, and I'm going to find myself a job. But again, failure does not stop following me. The pandemic happened and I was there again, jobless, sitting and waiting for the right opportunity to come by. And then started my podcast. I'll take you through that journey also. But yeah, for now, I'm a podcaster. So some of the companies that I have had the privilege to work with, I was in Dubai for 3 years and India 5 years in terms of my career. So I worked with KPMG Lower Gulf. I worked with 89.1 Radio 4, which is the Bollywood radio station in Dubai. I worked with Savill and Goldsworth Limited, SHL, which is a Gartner company. And I've started my marketing career with Times Internet, Scoop on Dunya. So I've been very blessed when it comes to, you know, these companies that I have worked with. And now, as you all know, that I am this podcaster sitting in front of you and taking you through my journey so that there is something that you may be able to pick up and let's see how it goes. The story goes back to 25th May 2020. Exactly, I think, little more than a month and a half ago, I started my podcast. I launched my first episode where I am actually and only introducing myself. And again, it was only when I was introducing myself, I realized that I'm a failure. And that episode got more than 1,000 views. Like imagine something that I'm so ashamed of admitting got me over 1,000 views. That says something, right? And not just that, episodes after that have also got more than 1,000 views. I've been able to get some of the dream guests a person could only imagine of getting on board. And all of this I have done with zero marketing spends. Like I have not boosted any post. I have not done any Google ads, no Facebook ads, no Instagram promotions, nothing. Absolutely zero, all organic. And I'm here to share my secrets with you. Some of the people that I have interviewed are on the screen. I want to very quickly see on the chat box if you can recognize either of these. Can you recognize either of these? I'm watching the chat box now. Quickly, punch in at least one of these you will recognize. Type in the chat box if you know their names. There are three people on the screen. Do you recognize any? If you do, just punch in their names on the chat box. Okay, Vishakha and Nachiket, I get that you all don't recognize. None of these. Wow. Okay. No, everybody's saying a no. Oh, no. Mini Mathur, right. Right. Thank you, Anushka. Thank you, Reema. Okay, at least one person recognizable compared to others. All right. So we've all heard the song Pink Lips, Pink Lips. So the first one, the lady in pink is Khushbu Grewal, the Bollywood singer. She works mainly with Neeth Brothers and she's a singer in Bollywood and she sung the song Pink Lips. Second is, we've used his website multiple times, but we failed to realize who he is. He is the CEO of Groupon and the co-founder of Nearby.com, Mr. Ankur Variku. He's also a motivational speaker and an angel investor. And finally, it is Mini Mathur. Mini Mathur, you may have seen her last on Mind the Malhotras or Mini Me on National Geographic. And very famous stint of hers was Indian Idol. So, you know, these are the people that I got on board like within a month and a half. I'm in front of you. I've interviewed these guys. And I want to take you back to 2014 when I started my first marketing job. What happened is, I was in Times Internet, and I had this colleague of mine. She was studying BMM like all, most of you guys are, right? And one day she received a voucher from Jabong.com. That back in the day, there was Jabong, Myntra and Flipkart, and Jabong got acquired by Myntra. So she got a voucher worth 3,000 rupees to shop online for free from Jabong.com. Like, imagine you're receiving a voucher today from Myntra for 3,000 rupees to shop online for free. Like, it's a dream, right? Imagine you're in your job and plus you get to shop for free. How amazing is that? So I asked her, why would you receive these vouchers? And she's like, I'm an influencer. And back in 2014, I was like, okay, what does that even mean? And how did you manage to get there? And she's like, you know what? I started this blog when I was in college doing my BMM. And we had this as a project that, you know, we start our own blog. And, you know, then I never stopped blogging. And here I am. I'm now an influencer. And that's why I received these free vouchers. Like, that is so amazing. I wished I was in BMM. And I wished I had started a blog earlier than later. And, you know, I would have been that girl who would have received those free vouchers for shopping online. Then comes 2017. I gathered some courage. And what I did was I blocked the handle Behen Code on Instagram because I loved the name that I came up with. And I thought I wanted to have a podcast. And I was like, sure, I'm going to do that. You know, I'll do it. So I just blocked the handle and did nothing about it until 25th May 2020. Imagine. And, you know, the beautiful thing about failure is that at the end, something or someone always gives up. It is either you who gives up and quits or the obstacle or the failure that gives up and makes way for your success to come through. It's one of my favorite quotes, which I wanted to share with you, because this is my reality. It has finally happened, and it is happening. I am finally winning now, and I want you to win too. I genuinely want you to win with me. I want all of us to win together. I want all of us to have our own podcasts, and I want all of us to do what we are so, so afraid to do. I want all of us to start. I want all of us to be that influencer who receives these free shopping vouchers and, you know, to review products, receives products to review them, and, you know, who gets paid to do ad campaigns for brands. And, you know, I want us all to have that dream life. And how do we do that? We just need to start. We don't have to think too much ahead. We just have to take one step at a time, and all we need to do is start. And I am here to help you start. I'm here to share my failures with you so that you do not make the same mistakes that I made. So 2020, let's just start. It's game time, right? So before we dive into the conversation, I very quickly want to understand that you are here on a Sunday morning with some expectations, right? When you read about the poster, you read about me, you obviously had some expectation. So what was it? I want to understand what is it that you're expecting today to take away with you. Very quickly on the chat box, what is it that you're expecting? I'm giving you exactly a minute. What are you expecting to learn today so that I can focus on that area more than the other areas? I want you all to very quickly type, what is it that you're expecting today to learn here? For everyone who's just joined in and for everyone who's there. Information about marketing, great. All right, Swati. Marketing, Nachiket, okay. How to start podcast with influencers, okay. Some more about podcast, okay. Getting to know more about podcasting. Content creating, okay. Marketing, what exactly is podcasting? All right. Oh, that's a great question. Okay. Fair. So, how many of us listen to podcasts here? How many of us, I listen to On Purpose with Jay Shetty, which is one of the famous podcasts. Do you listen to any podcasts? I want to quickly understand that. Quickly on the chat box. Do you listen to any podcast? Yes. Which ones? Can you name one or two? Vishen Lakhani, Mind Valley. Wow. I like that, Vineet. Okay. I'm reading all your chats. So be very quick in typing. You know, try to be a keyboard ninja. Okay, Kritika. Uncut Kritika. All right. Sarah Jacobs. All right. Great. Wow. So some of us here know what podcasting is. Okay, Janvi also is a Jay Shetty fan like me. Okay. Gary, Ranveer, Alavadia, right. Oscar, Salil. Salil Acharya is very closely connected to Khushbu Grewal, who is my guest. All right, I get it. Wow. Okay, great. So some of us do know what podcasting here is, and we also have our favorite podcasts. But for those of us who do not know, like imagine what Netflix is to TV, podcast is to radio. And it's like it's a depository of audio files, right? And, you know, you can access it at any time. And the other difference between a podcast and a radio would be that podcast is generally very in-depth conversation. Secondly, it is more of a personal experience sharing of the podcaster with their audience and not just, a knowledge sharing session. So that's what a podcast is. It's an audio file that you put on the internet and you can access at any time on any device and you can listen to it anywhere that you are going. But now podcasting has evolved and podcasting is not just limited to audio podcasting, but it has also navigated to video podcasting. AIB had a video podcast. If you know, Ranbir Kapoor was on that podcast. That's just one example of a video podcast. And mine is also a video podcast called Behenpur, which I host on YouTube. And the audio podcast we host on other platforms, and I will come to that. That's a module in our journey today. But yes, great. So now we're clear with what a podcast is. And why now is the good time to have a podcast? Y'all should be really thankful that you have teachers who recognize a trend that is going on in terms of marketing and they're able to identify it, pick it up and tap on it and have somebody come here and talk to you about it so that you can ride on that big opportunity that is there. So we all know our Pradhan Mantri, Mr. Modi, and we all, right, even SRK was on the AIB podcast, right? So Man Ki Baat is also a podcast, right? We are all aware. And any guesses? Do you even know that podcasting can make you money? If you didn't, then surprise, podcasting and radio makes a lot of money. And do you have any idea on how much Man Ki Baat by Mr. Modi makes in a year? Any guesses on the chat? 5 crores a year since the last 4 years. Imagine, that is the amount of money that Man Ki Baat is making. When a lot of us don't even know that, you know, it's there, it's live on some podcasting platform. Imagine. So as per a recent PwC report, India is world's third largest podcast listening market. And it is only going to increase by 2023. The market is going to open up crazy. So there is so much opportunity in that area. People are moving from videos and, TV and Netflix to podcasting. People want to know their real life experiences and they want to come to podcasting. So this is your chance. Like, this is like a blue ocean right now. You can just swim in whatever area you like. This big an opportunity is difficult to come by. Like, imagine when YouTube started, and if you and I were here, or you and I were, you know, maybe 25, 30 year olds that we are today, we would have started YouTubing, right? But we weren't there then. But now we are here, and podcasting is clearly going to be big. We know this. So we need to tap on this opportunity. And again, like I said, this is a workshop and you are expected to put in the work. I will direct and facilitate you from this point on. So all of us have our pens and diaries with us. Today, what we are going to do is we're going to figure out, at least, like, I can see 97 people online right now. It's switching between 97 and 105 people, right? And I aim to start 97 to 105 podcasts today, right now, with me on this platform. So very quickly, give me a shout out if you have your notebooks and pens with you. Type in a yes. Quickly, everybody. I just see Divya, Nachiket. Very quickly, everybody. Okay. Vaibhavi, Shefali, Dhawan. All right. Siddharth, Aishwarya. Great. Okay. So we move on. So here we are starting building our podcast. The very first thing that you need to start a podcast is that you need to know what is it going to be about. Like, and it cannot be something very random. Like, so how we go about this is that I'll tell you how I started it, and then you have to tell me what is it for you that's going to take you to start it. All right, so here goes. So for me, how it worked is, like, I've always been a fan of lipsticks. I've always been a fan of Dubai. And I've always been a fan of sharing stories. I love listening to people. I love observing people. I am that awkward cutlet in the mall who is sitting in the food court and aggressively observing people. I love people like that, which is why I asked you to turn on your videos earlier. I would have loved seeing all of you guys. And unfortunately, we cannot facilitate that right now. But that is how much I love people. And I want to listen to them. I want to listen to their experiences. I want to listen to their stories. And I want to learn from it. And I want to share it with, you know, people that are out there. So I'm essentially a storyteller. So I always knew that my podcast had to be either of these three points that work for me: lipsticks, Dubai, or stories, right? So your podcast, your forte has to be something that you love and you're passionate about. So the very first step is finding your forte. So right now, I'm giving you a minute, like legitimately, I'm giving you 1 minute to think about, and again, you know, you don't really have to be very specific right now that, oh, no, I think my idea is really stupid. I mean, who has a podcast about lipsticks? I was thinking that, you know, for 3 years I was thinking, what if I want to share stories? People are not interested. Excuse me. I just proved myself incorrect, right? So in the very same way, I want you to think, like, you know, even if it sounds very stupid to you in your head, it's fine. I want you to think about what is it that you love. You know, just two things that you love, you know, it could be any two things. So, and I want you to type at least one of those in the chat boxes today. Like right now, I'm giving you 1 minute. Sports and automobile. I like Vinny. He's always the first to answer. I love him. Esports. Exploring places. Wow. Yes. Food. All right. Sports. How many of us watch Gaurav Kapoor's Breakfast with the Champions? You know, that's a video podcast. That's around sports and that's around cricket. Like, you know, you can imagine anything and you can have a podcast about it. It could be literally anything. Internet has opened the world for us. Travel and Dance, podcast of Fangirl. Deeksha Fangirl of what? Someone who roasts like Carrie Minati. Awesome. Makeup and artistry. Amazing, Apurva. Sketching. Amazing. I would love to join your podcast. Animals. Wow. Exploring places. Wow. Random conversations and dance. Amazing. Researchers. Awesome. Great. I love the answers that are coming in. Right? So write two of these of, you know, passions in your diary right now. Write down. My forte is one, blah, blah, blah. Two, blah, blah, blah. Are we done with that? Quickly give me a yes in the chat box. Sharing pet stories. Wow. Oh, yeah. I would love to know more about your dog because I want to be a dog mom or a cat mom, but I'm afraid. My plant just died. I'm not a good plant mom. I need help with that. Okay. So we've written this down. We move on to the next point. Now the next point is finding your tribe. Like, I love lipsticks. And my love for lipsticks was so evident on my social media that my female friends would reach out to me to ask me, hey, what lipstick are you wearing? Hey, do you know about this lipstick? Do you know about Huda Beauty because you stay in the Middle East? How good or bad is it? Because it's a little expensive. So I don't know if I would want to spend 2,000, 2,400 on a lipstick here in India, right? And for me in Dubai, it was like 100, 150 dirhams, which is like equivalent of 100, 150 rupees. So, you know, so the key idea here is that I want to find people who love lipsticks as much as I love lipsticks. So if you said sports, I want you to figure out people who love sports as much as you love sports. And who are these people? These are your audiences, right? And how do you identify your audience? So there is something called as an audience persona. This is a very important marketing topic. You know, if you happen to pursue your MBA in marketing, you will come across this term, which is called as an audience persona. But to keep it very simple for you, what I'm asking you to do is, I want you to write down four things, four personality traits of your audience. Like, again, I'll take the example of my own podcast. I knew that my key audience for Behen Code would be, one, women, two, women who are aged between 25 and 40 years of age. Three, women. These are the women who want to be financially independent or want to be emotionally independent and looking for inspiration. So these were the three traits that I was looking for in my audience. What happened, I will share with you. I started with this goal that my target audience is this. So I want you to write down कि अगर आपने लिखा है traveler, तो ये traveler कौन है? जो solo travel करता है वो है, या जो group में travel करता है वो है, या ये solo travel वो ये चलो traveler है, तो ये ऐसा solo traveler है कि जो you know wants to stay in hostels and you know Airbnbs. या तो नहीं, ये सोलो ट्रैवलर जो है ये सिर्फ होटल्स में रहता है बिकॉज उसको एक्सपेरिमेंट नहीं करना है. सो दैट आई वांट यू टू राइट डाउन एटलीस्ट फोर पर्सनालिटी ट्रेट्स ऑफ योर टारगेट ऑडियंस. राइट, वेरी क्विकली, लाइक आई एम गिविंग यू अगेन लाइक एग्जैक्टली 1.5 or 2 minutes टू राइट डाउन के ये पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेट्स क्या है. सो एंड इफ यू कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन वन ऑफ द पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेट्स इन द चैट बॉक्स. It's 11:35 on my clock. I'm giving you time until 11:37. Like someone said, sports. So, sports mein kya? Badminton, tennis, swimming, chess, indoor games, outdoor games, dance hai. तो कौन सा डांस है? सालसा है, बेली डांसिंग है, कॉन्टेम्प्रेरी डांसिंग है, फैन गर्ल तो किसकी फैन गर्ल, स्केचिंग तो क्या स्केच करेंगे, मेकअप तो मेकअप में कौन सा, मतलब जो एवरीडे न्यूट्रल मेकअप होगा या फन मेकअप या एकदम एक्सट्रीम एक्सपेरिमेंटल मेकअप होगा, लाइक हु पीपल हु लव डांस क्लासिकल बॉलीवुड, आई लाइक दैट स्वाति. सो या आई वांट यू टू राइट डाउन फोर पर्सनालिटी ट्रेट्स, इनका डेमोग्राफिक्स आपको लिखना है कि ये लोग कहाँ मिलेंगे, मतलब मुंबई में मिलेंगे या पुणे में ज्यादा मिलेंगे ऐसे लोग मुझे, जो जिनको फॉर एग्जाम्पल डांस सीखना है, या दे कुड बी एनी वेयर इन इंडिया. तो ओके फाइन, एनी वेयर इन इंडिया है या एनी वेयर अक्रॉस द ग्लोब है, तो व्हाट इज देयर एज ग्रुप, व्हाट इज देयर जेंडर. सो समथिंग लाइक क्रिकेट, आई एम नॉट वेरी श्योर के व्हाट द रेशियो ऑफ मेल टू फीमेल इज गोइंग टू बी. एंड अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग इनसाइट दैट आई वुड वॉन्ट टू शेयर विथ यू टूडे इज दैट I originally started my podcast for women, and today half the audience is men. Like, आपको नहीं पता कि किसको पसंद आएगा नहीं आएगा, but you have to start with something, some intention in your mind. So I want you to figure out that intention. Like, my intention was women जो inspiration के लिए lookout कर रही है, but then it turned out that men were also looking out for inspiration and they are open to learning from women. How amazing is that, right? And so now half of my audience is men, which is wonderful. So आप कुछ decide करते हो, होता कुछ है, but आपको कुछ decide तो करना होगा. You need a point to start. So this is your starting point. A person who travels on low budget and stays more in locality and enjoys food and culture. Great, I like that. Akshada. People who love yoga, college students, and health caution women. Okay. People who love animals. Okay. But then, कौन से एनिमल्स, लाइक अगेन सिर्फ कैट लवर्स या सिर्फ डॉग लवर्स या सिर्फ पांडा लवर्स, यू नो बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक, राइट? आई होप हमने बहुत क्लियरली और अच्छे से ऑडियंस पर्सोना हमारा डिफाइन किया है. जस्ट गिव मी अ येस इन द चैट बॉक्स इफ यू आर डन आइडेंटिफाइंग द फोर ट्रेट्स ऑफ योर ऑडियंसेस. Very quickly. Okay, Raksha, I get it. Cat lovers. Exactly. See, animal lovers are different from cat lovers. So you have to be very specific and very narrow. कि ये मेरी audience है. So very quickly, give me a yes if you're done. Okay. Random conversations with any age group. Fine. Okay, yes. So I get it that we are done with finding our tribe. Now the next point is finding their habitat. Now that we know. लेट्स से फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगेन फॉर बहन कोड, नाउ आई नो वेरी क्लियरली दैट आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड दीज वीमेन लार्जली ऑन इंस्टाग्राम एंड लार्जली ऑन यूट्यूब. लाइक वेर डू वी गो टू वॉच मोटिवेशनल वीडियोज? यूट्यूब. वील टाइप ऑन पर्पज विद जय शेट्टी, और वील टाइप जय शेट्टी, और वील टाइप माइंड वैली, और वील टाइप रॉबिन शर्मा, राइट? That's where we look up for motivation. So I knew कि ये दोनों जो है ये मेरे key platforms है, मुझे यहाँ पे मेरी audience मिलने वाली है, right? So that way I want you to put some thought in figuring out कि आपको आपकी target audience कहाँ मिल सकती है. जैसे कि अगर travel है तो ये travelers कहाँ पे मुझे ज़्यादा मिलेंगे, इंस्टाग्राम पे मिलेंगे या वो जो फेसबुक ग्रुप्स होते हैं ट्रैवलिंग के वहाँ मिलेंगे, या ये मुझे ट्विटर पे ज़्यादा मिलेंगे या ये मुझे लिंक्डइन पे मिलेंगे. आई डोंट नो वेयर यू विल फाइंड योर टारगेट ऑडियंस, बट ओनली यू विल नो बिकॉज आपके पास इनके पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेट्स है. नाउ इमेजिन समवन लेट्स से के हु इज लुकिंग फॉर डांस वीडियोज, राइट? सो डांस एक विजुअल आर्ट है, राइट? तो ये मुझे विजुअल प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे मिलेंगे. तो विजुअल प्लेटफॉर्म्स कौन से हैं? फेसबुक है, यूट्यूब है, इंस्टाग्राम पे है. नाउ इफ आई लुक फॉर डांसर्स ऑन ट्विटर, चांसेस आर कि मुझे कम मिलेंगे. बहुत डिफिकल्ट है. ट्विटर पे जनरली लोग वीडियोस कम डालते हैं, ट्वीट्स ज्यादा डालते हैं, राइट? सो ट्विटर इज नॉट द राइट प्लेटफॉर्म टू टारगेट फॉर माई टारगेट ऑडियंस, गिवन दैट आई एम लुकिंग फॉर डांसर्स. इन दैट केस इट्स यूट्यूब. सो आई वॉन्ट यू टू टेक अ मिनट एंड फिगर आउट के सारे सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स से. दिवेश, आई लाइक हाउ प्रोएक्टिव यू आर. आपने ऑलरेडी लिख दिया कि आपका ऑडियंस कहाँ मिलेगा. एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग,
कि वेयर विल यू फाइंड योर टारगेट ऑडियंस. ठीक है, वेरी क्विकली गिव मी योर आंसर्स इन द चैट बॉक्स एंड ऑल्सो राइट डाउन इन योर डायरी. वो मत भूलना, वो ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. तो ये चैट चला जाएगा, वो डायरी आपके पास रहने वाली है. Instagram and YouTube. Okay. There is a lot of audience on Facebook for travelers, huh? I'm just saying. Reddit. Wow. I have never used Reddit. Yeah. Too nice. Cat lovers on Instagram. ये cat lovers तो शायद Twitter पे भी मिलेंगे. Yeah. There are a lot of cat videos and pictures on Twitter. Dance, YouTube, very specific, very targeted. Okay, but have identify. Please identify two social media platforms. Imagine, God forbid, जैसे TikTok बंद हो गया, YouTube बंद हो जाएगा एक दिन, तो क्या करोगे? पूरा don't put all your eggs in one basket. Divide your eggs in two baskets, please. So please figure out two platforms at least, if not three. Right? Okay. So I hope we are done with figuring out our the habitat of our audience, right? So give me a yes in the chat box if we are done. Okay. So this step is called as identifying the channel. Just give me a minute. Hello. Hello. Am I audible to you? Please give me a yes on the chat box. Okay, thank you. Sorry, I had a call that I couldn't. So this part is called as identifying the channel. So in this case, what we did is we found our audience and we identified that which is the social media platform, like at least two, where we can find them, right? Now moving on is the very, very important element. Like imagine you are in this meeting and you met this very interesting person and you had a great conversation and aapko unka naam hi nahi pata hai ya unka naam itna common tha ki aap bhool gaye, right? या इतना कॉमन है कि आपके लिए सर्च करना डिफिकल्ट हो गया. लेट्स सी, आई मेट पूजा एट एन इवेंट एंड आई लव्ड पूजा एंड हर नेम वाज पूजा शाह. नो ऑफेंस टू एनी पूजा हु इज हियर, बट आई एम सॉरी, आई एम स्ट्रगलिंग टू फाइंड यू ऑन सोशल मीडिया, राइट? तो नाउ व्हाट डू वी डू? सो विच इज वाई योर नेम इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट when it comes to building your podcast's online identity, right? So how did I go about building the name Behen Code? It's a very interesting story. So I wanted a name that was catchy and I wanted a name that had the word sisterhood in it. So I thought boys always had this bro code, you know, chalna bro, we have a bro code, right? We always hear bro code, right? And women generally are like, we get into cat fights a lot of times, and which is something we shouldn't be doing. Imagine, like, we are supporting each other, how wonderful that would be. Like, you know, men, you see, they always keep covering up for each other and, you know, No, he's not gone there. Wo party mein nahi hai. He's still in the office only. So, you know, that's how men cover up for each other always. And women are like, oh no, she's not there. She's not in the office. She's in the party. I know. So this is what I absolutely hated, you know. And I saw a lot of this happening around me. And I was like, I'm not going to, you know, take this. I want a community where women support women. So which is why I came up with the name Behen Code. Now, what works for Behenkod is that the name is catchy for obvious reasons. If you did not get it wrong, then you're thinking something. So the name has to be very catchy. That's a given, right? And now that you know Behenkod, it's hard for you to forget Behenkod. And second is that you will be very easily able to find me on social media. You just type Behenkod and my profile is there. It's really that simple. And three, you're not going to be able to forget me. Again, like I said. So it works in all the ways. And I'll show you one video to prove that why the name is very important. I'm sorry, this clip is going to have a little bit of Hindi because my guest is Hindi. Tell me if you can see the Minimathur tab. Do you see that? Can somebody type a yes or say a yes? Okay, thank you. So I'm going to play this clip to prove that why name is important. Okay, so just for some context, I had asked Minimathur that why she said a yes to me, and this was her answer.
मेरे यहाँ इसलिए होना कि आपके 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 रिस्पांस में एक स्वीट सिंसेरिटी थी और एक बहुत ही आई कुड सी द बबलिंग एंथुसियाज्म इन व्हाट यू डू आई वेंट एंड स्पीक टू यू आल्सो बिकॉज़ आई लव द नेम आई वेंट एंड स्टॉक योर
Right? So you, so, okay, Sejal says that the audio, right. Hello? Yes, Kinjal?
Ma'am, can you hear me? Yeah. Ma'am, there was an echo in the video. I think you will have to mute your audio.
Mine?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will do that. I will give you a rerun of the...
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
इसलिए बोला क्योंकि आपके आपके रिस्पॉन्स में एक बहुत ही स्वीट सिंसेरिटी थी और एक बहुत ही आई कुड सी द बबलिंग एंथुसियाज्म इन व्हाट यू डू आई वेंट एंड सीक्रेटली आल्सो बिकॉज आई लव द नेम आई वेंट एंड स्टॉक योर हैंडल एंड आई सेड ओके दिस गर्ल डज गुड वर्क आई हैवंट सीन एनी ऑफ योर शोज ऑफ कोर्स बट फॉर मी एनीथिंग द फैक्ट दैट यू हैव अप्रिशिएटेड माय पोस्ट्स एंड यू रेजोनेट विद इट और आपको वो सब चीजें अच्छी लगती है जो कहना चाहती हूँ इससे बड़ा गिफ्ट क्या होता है सो ऑफ कोर्स मैंने आपको इसलिए वहां किया और आपका नाम बहुत अनयूजुअल है फिलोनी इट्स सच अ आई वांटेड टू मीट यू
वाज द ऑडियो क्लियर दिस टाइम अराउंड प्लीज गिव मी अ यस ऑसम ग्रेट सो डिड यू हियर दैट शी सेड दैट She loved the handle name because it was very different and she could instantly figure out that what I was doing, right? So this means that the name that you use for your podcast becomes very important. It is that door that opens a lot of opportunities for you. And then of course, whatever content you put, that matters. But the first entry point, the first touch point that you're going to have with your listener is going to be your name, right? So it becomes very important to have a name that's catchy or that's easy to remember and easy to find. So now, what I want you to do in the next 1 minute is to think of a very catchy or a sassy name for your podcast, right? Please do that and I would love if you share it with me here. In it to win it. I love that. I would love more podcast names coming in. Take a minute or two to think. I'm giving you that time. Okay, hair and makeup. Hi, Kia. I don't know if I get the pronunciation right, but I like how you're thinking. That's how you have to think. Vistar me charcha. I love that, Nachiket. I love Jay Shetty's podcast. It's on purpose. Like, it's a very purposeful conversation. So, like, I actually started my blog called as Dubai Lifestyle. It's called, I will punch in the name, Dubai Lifestyle. That rhymes with Dubai Lifestyle when I was in Dubai. Mima's Life, wow. I would definitely follow Mima's Life. Dance Move With Me, wow. Listening Lipika, wow. That's Introvert Anu, wow. I love that. Comedy Plus, okay. But again, Comedy Plus could be a name which is difficult to find. Sketch On Board, I love that. Suffer With Hum Suffer, amazing. Helping Brothers, yes. You can improvise part. Sit With Sid, wow. Honey Bud Bus Podcast, okay. I am loving all the names that are coming in. Meow With Me, perfect. So when I think of Meow With Me, I know it's something to do with cats, right? When it's Behen Code, I know it's something to do with women and sisterhood. So Sketch On Board, I know it's got something to do with sketching. So it's a very clever way to infuse your purpose in your name, Travel With Me. It could be very common, Preetam. So, you know, think something better. And Travel With Me, agar main likhu, to bahut sari channels aayenge. I wouldn't know ki Preetam Joshi ka kaun sa channel hai, right? So I'm just trying to give you pointers and guide you into getting the perfect name. You know, Helping Brothers is amazing. I would still want you to think a little more. Path, Travel Through Lens, okay. Omkar, it could be slightly difficult to identify your podcast from someone else's. So, you know, think about you. Sketch a few. Okay, wow. Boom Bang Comedy, all right. I love that. It sounds funny. Okay. So, yeah, you get the point, right? The point is you have to have a name that's really catchy. That's key element one. Now we move to the next key element. I have no idea, and if you haven't already, please read the book. Start With Why by Simon Sinek. He is brilliant. And there is only one concept in the whole book, is that, can you see the screen? The PPT again. Yes. So the whole idea in this book, and the only idea that he tries to explain and sell to us in this book, is that we need to very clearly define our purpose, why we are doing what we are doing. That's our purpose, right? And we need to communicate our purpose very clearly. So if you go to at Behen Code on Instagram, you will very clearly find that I am doing this because I want to share stories and I want to help women become financially and emotionally independent. And there is no place where I do not communicate this. This is my purpose. This is why I'm doing it. Like, I am here on this podcast because I want you to win. I want you to not make the mistakes that I have made. I could have been a failure, but you don't have to be. You learn from my mistakes. That's my purpose. That's my why. And I communicated it very clearly with you when we started, right? The same way, you have to communicate your why with your target audience, it becomes very important. Here is another example of Ankur Variku, the group CEO and the founder of nearby.com, telling me very clearly that he came on my podcast because he loved what I was doing. He loves what my purpose is and he wanted to support it. Here, I will share the screen with you and I will mute myself so that there is no disturbance again.
I love what you stand for, Filoni. I love what the head coach stands for. I think it's a very, very important ideology. And I'm more than happy to support it in my small way. And couldn't be more excited and pressured by the first mail.
Was the audio and the video clear? Can someone type in a yes or say a yes? Awesome. So do you realize that how powerful your purpose becomes, that people want to support you in what you're doing? The minute he knew that I was doing this to help women become independent, he was all game for it. So right now, I want you to take a minute and figure out why you are doing your podcast, because that will be a very key element in attracting the audience that you want, in attracting the guests that you want. I don't know if you want a podcast where you just share your stories, or I don't know if you want a podcast where you invite others to share their stories. Whatever it is, your purpose becomes the reason why your target audience comes to you, right? So if you said you want to have your Meow With Me podcast, why? Because I'm a cat lover, because cats are amazing and they need a platform to be discussed. And they need, and you know, if I want to have random conversations with people is what you said, then I want to have random conversations with people because why? What's your why? Write it down in your diary and then share it with me here in the chat. I'm reading all your answers. I really want to know, why is it, if you're passionate about lipsticks, why are you so passionate about lipsticks? The minute I'm wearing a lipstick and the minute I'm wearing heels, I feel so confident. I am another woman. If I'm not wearing this lipstick today right now, I may not be so, confident of myself. But lipstick really empowers me. And that's my reality. So I can legit have a podcast on lipsticks because lipstick empowers me. And if you are someone who resonates with me, you're going to follow me. That, wow, I also feel very good when I apply a lipstick, ma'am. I'm going to follow you. So what's your purpose? Write it down in your diary and write it down in the chat. I want to know. Thank you, Kinjal. Okay, to know their culture, Sejal. Can you please put more context to it? Because it's difficult for me to remember 90 people and 90 podcast names. So can you like be more specific that I want to have a podcast on women because I want to help them become independent. I want to have a podcast on men. Yeah, no. Wow, Swati, I like that. Like many people have no one to talk to and share things with, which is why random conversations and dance to encourage people. Amazing. I love that purpose. So, you know, if you love cricket, why, just think for a minute, why do you love cricket so much? Because, you know, maybe cricket makes me happy. And if cricket is your happy place, our podcast is amazing for both of us, for you and for me, because we think alike, right? So, what's your why? I want you to figure that out right now. Right? Are you all thinking about your why? Give me a yes if you are. To share dressing good is not so hard. Oh, I struggle with dressing up every single day. I would love your podcast. I want people to enjoy their life by traveling around the world. Wow. Yeah, traveling opens up a lot of experiences. I want to explore places to know their culture and share it with other people. All right. If you're thinking about it, give me a yes. You are thinking about what's your why. You may not find it out right now in a minute, but at least just give me a yes so that I know you're thinking about it. Right? Great. Sports. Okay, to encourage people, health and fitness. Amazing. Highlight issues happening in India. All right. Great. So this is something that cannot be done like in a minute's time. So you have to really dig deep inside of yourself and find your reason for doing what you're doing. And now finally, we come to what's my type. Like, do I go for an audio podcast or do I go for a video podcast? Like, imagine I'm sharing stories with you of Mini Mathur or Ankur Variku, and you're listening to those stories and you don't have a face to it. Like right now, imagine that I just turn off my video and I'm just talking. You wouldn't be able to connect with me as much as you can right now in this moment when you are seeing my face, when you know that, oh, she is Filoni. Oh, she is the one who's a failure. Oh, she is the one who started Behen Code. There is a face to that story, right? So it becomes very important for me to have a face, which is why I chose that I wanted to have a video podcast where I'm telling you that this person is sharing their most personal story of, you know, maybe overcoming a divorce or, you know, overcoming someone's death, or maybe, you know, building that business, or, you know, maybe getting their first job as an anchor on TV or actor as a TV, or getting their first Bollywood singing break and all of that. And imagine you cannot see their face, you cannot connect better with them. So it became very important for me as a podcaster to choose video platform as a podcasting platform so that there is a face to that story. But there could be some podcasts where you know, for example, radio, you don't really need to even see the radio jockey, right? Because all you are interested is in what they have to say. It doesn't matter how they look. It doesn't matter who they are, you know, in terms of their physical personality. So it is only and only you who can choose that, okay, this is my audience. This is what I want to communicate. So what do I choose? Do I choose to communicate it with video or without video? That's a choice that you have to make and only you can make. So I want you to take like 30 seconds and think that this is my audience and what is the kind of podcast that would work for me. And I would love if you share the answers with me. Video or audio? Like, you don't have to be really pretty, like a makeup vlogger, to have a video podcast. You could just be a plain Jane like I am. But you could still have a video podcast. It really doesn't matter. So can you give me your answers in the chat? If you don't mind, I would love to read them. Would you opt for a video podcast or an audio podcast? Awesome. Sorry, my chat had frozen. I thought no one's answering. All right. I see a lot of video podcasters. Amazing. Both amazing. Yeah, exactly. Dance and conversation. Yes, video podcast. I love that, Swati. Okay, awesome. Okay, Janvi wants to switch to audio because she would be more confident. All right, that makes sense. Great. All right, so we move on to the key point here that I was trying to make, that the type of podcast will depend on the purpose of the podcast. Right? If you're a dancer, then you know you need a visual platform. If you maybe just want to share a story, you may choose audio platform also.
So it is you who will define that what your purpose is and what platform it needs. Only you can do that. Let no one else tell you what you have to do and what you need to do. And finally, like I said, add some magic to it. Now, what is magic? Any guesses? Like for a podcast to become something that everyone looks forward to, like I now legit have people who message me that when are you releasing your next episode? Why do you think that has happened? Any guesses? Very quickly, give me the guesses if you have any. What is that key element? What is the reason why a podcast becomes very dipping? Content, real, the way you talk to interact, experiences, close enough, Ruchika. Your unique point about the topic, Lipika, is also very close. I'll tell you. The magic is you. The magic is your experiences. The magic is your opinions. And the magic is your take on it. Like, I cannot be Mini Mathur if I am trying to be a host. But I sure can be the best Filoni that the world has ever seen. Like, I know in college I was good, but I know now I'm better, right? So that's me. Like, I can be the best version of myself. And all that I need to have a personal connection with my audience is that I need to be myself. Like, imagine I was sitting here in front of you pretending that I was someone else. You would be easily able to make it out that, you know, she's fake and I don't like her. And all of you must have left by now already that, you know, she's just a pretense and we don't like her. But when you're real, when you're yourself, you know, when we share our own experiences is when we become magic and we become so powerful. Like, you are here because I shared my magic with you. I told you that, you know, I'm not a success. I'm a failure. And you love that about me, that I'm real, I'm honest, I'm sincere. And that's why you're sticking around with me, right? So in your podcast, please remember, if you're trying to be like an influencer, don't try to copy that boho girl or anyone else. Try and be yourself. That's the real magic. You get me? Give me a yes if you agree with that. Thank you. Now, what is the frequency of your podcast? This should have been a spoonful of salt, but it looks like sugar salt. So, you know, salt to taste, same way, frequency to taste, to match the taste of your audience and choice of your audience. You know, your audience would be someone like wouldn't see more than one video or audio a week, then, you know, you have to just churn out one episode a week. Your audience maybe wants a lot of content, so you may have to have, you know, an episode out every day. Your audience is fine with twice a week, so, you know, you churn it out twice a week. But this you will be able to figure out only and only by trial and error. And like me, for that matter, I am doing between one and two episodes a week right now. So yeah, I mean, I'm also still figuring out what works. I'm trying new things. Okay, this works great, I'll keep it. This doesn't work, all right, fine, I'll not keep it. The important parts. Now that we figured this out, we don't know how to execute it, right? So I'm going to also share the tools that I personally have used and are very easy, and all of these are very free to use. First is, if you use your mobile to record your podcast, you can do that very simply. Just download this app, Anchor FM. Download that. All you need to do is it'll have this recording button. Press that record button. Legit with these headphones that I'm wearing right now. I am not wearing any fancy headphones. Don't have any. Same way. Same headphones. You record everything. It gets saved on your mobile. they give you the choice to add a background music and adjust the volume of the music, save and share. That's it. Your podcast is out there, your audio podcast. It's that easy. If you are Mr. or Miss Smarty Pants, like I am, you want to do it, you know, more professionally, you want to do on a laptop, there are these two applications. For MacBook, there is GarageBand. For Windows, the normal laptop, you have Audacity. Both of these are 100% free, supremely easy to use. There are a lot of YouTube videos available on how to use Audacity. I started with Audacity and I still use Audacity. So yeah, in spite of me having a MacBook, I prefer sticking to Audacity because that's where I started and that's my comfort zone. So, you know, you can actually make tapes, you can actually create music on Audacity. It's that brilliant and it's 100% free. It will never ask you to pay money. How do you distribute? Like, there are a lot of platforms where you can distribute your audio podcasts. There is Spotify and there is Apple Podcast. There is also Google Podcast. And, you know, and there are a host of applications where you can put audio podcast. But these two are very well recognized. Spotify works on Androids too. And Apple Podcast is iPhones only. So again, if your audience is someone who uses iPhone more than Android, then you know that you need to be there on Apple Podcast as well, right? So again, this decision of distribution, also you will make basis your audience. I record my podcasts on Zoom. Can you imagine? I Zoom called Mini Mathur. I Zoom called Ankur Variku. I Zoom called Khushbu Grewal. It gives you the permission to record. You record the episode, you record the conversation, you save it on your laptop, just add the starting and the ending cover and put it out. How hard is it? And you guys are media students, you are studying management, media, and all of these courses. How hard is it to go online and learn editing? There are so many free editors available. Use them. Everything's free. Congratulations. Please, a huge round of applause for all of you guys. You are now officially certified in podcasting. You can legit have your own podcast. Give me a shout out if you're going to start your podcast today. It doesn't matter how poor you think you may be in this, or, you know, maybe you don't have the great equipment to start. Watch my first two episodes. They are horrible. I had an old laptop, poor lighting. My face is dark. I didn't know editing. Doesn't matter. We just need to start. I love the enthusiasm, all of you guys. So now I have a favor to ask you. If you derive any value of this podcasting conversation, go on YouTube and give me a follow on Behen Code right now, and even on Instagram. I want all of you guys on my social media handles. I want to see you guys there. Let's take a minute off, sip some water, come back and start with content marketing. Exactly. Take a minute off, sip some water and come back. Do not leave your diaries and pens because there's so much more to learn. And if I don't see at least 95 subscribers, I'm not starting the second part, all right? Lovely. Rima did tell me that the students are amazing and they are very interactive, like they're very responsive to anything that you may ask. And I actually see that. And I love this audience that is, you know, interactive. And I'm loving all of you guys. Thank you for being so responsive. So do I have 100 subscribers on my YouTube and Instagram? Can I assume that? We start with content marketing in like 30 seconds. How sweet of you, Swati. All right, tell me if you can see my screen. I'm unable to share my screen. I have no idea why. What screen do you see? Can someone tell me what screen do you see? Okay, you cannot see. I will now. Okay. Now this presentation is going to help you with your jobs, first jobs also. And I'm not kidding even 1%. I've learned this on the job. And it has helped me immensely, and I'm sure it helped you too. Perfect. You can see content. Great. That's my goal. So do we start? Give me a quick yes if you're ready and all set to learn content marketing. Awesome. I love the energy. Okay, so I love colors, and I think we should really experiment with a lot of colors and not stick to the boring monochrome schemes. Can anybody tell me what is content marketing? Unmute yourself and just give me the answer if you know what content marketing is. Anybody, any idea what content marketing is? If you're going to take the effort of Googling, here's the answer. Please, can you read through the screen? Content marketing, a type of marketing that involves the creation and sharing of online materials, such as videos and social media posts, that does not explicitly promote a brand, but is intended to stimulate interest in its products or services, right? This is the Google definition of content marketing. Yes, blog, everything. Anything that you put out is content. Today, we are having this conversation, and what your college and what your marketing professors Kinjal and Reema are going to do is that they're going to save this conversation and they're going to put it out on YouTube, right? What is that? That is also content marketing, right? People will go to, you know, Patkar College's YouTube channel and they will watch this video, right? Which is amazing piece of content that they're going to put out. So that's also content marketing. So content marketing is everywhere because content is everywhere. So it's just that you may or may not be aware that this was happening. And now you know better that, you know, this is content marketing. So a very important decision that you have to make as a marketer when you take up your job is that what kind of marketing approach do you want to have? Do you want to have inbound marketing or do you want outbound marketing? I'll explain what inbound and outbound is. These sound like very fancy words, but they are very simple, and I have done this. So inbound marketing is when your customers look out for you and come to you, your website, your social media platforms. That is inbound marketing. People are coming in, which is why inbound. Clear? Another form of marketing is outbound marketing. Outbound is when the brand reaches out to their customers. Like I, as a brand, I'm going to my customer that, hey, you know, buy from us. Hey, buy from me. And when it's inbound marketing, the customer is telling me, hey, sell to me. So
you as a marketer, what mode of marketing would you prefer? Would you prefer inbound marketing where your customers come to you, or would you prefer outbound marketing where you go to your customer? What's more preferable? Give me your answer in the chat box. Inbound marketing, okay. Any takers for outbound marketing? Divesh, why would you choose outbound? Both, okay. No, ideally, imagine that you are so awesome and you've established your brand. So what would be preferable? That your customers come to you or you go to your customers? Ideally, you would want your customer to come to you and say that, you know, we want to purchase your products. We want to purchase your services. Like in my case, for my podcast, for me, inbound marketing would be the guest would come to me and tell me that, Kaloni, I want to be on your podcast, versus me reaching out to them and asking me, would you please be on my podcast, right? That would be an ideal situation. That would be like a dream come true. So every marketer's dream is to have amazing inbound marketing strategies work for them. Clear? Right, first outbound, then inbound. We're not talking about the process. I just wanted to check what is the ideal situation. So content marketing is a brilliant, brilliant source of inbound marketing. It's a very brilliant way to get inbound marketing, right? Now, why marketing? How did it help me in my podcast? And then we'll see how we can do that, right? So I got 1,000 plus views in multiple episodes. In fact, some episodes are reaching 2,000 now. Like a month and a half and zero spends. I'm not spending 1 rupee also on digital marketing because I'm bootstrapping. And I'm like, I've learned so much marketing in these 8 years. Now is the time to test my marketing skills. And it's working for me. It's a lot of effort, yes, but is the effort worth it? Absolutely. So I got 1,000 plus views in multiple episodes and I'm approaching 2,000 views on some. I'm getting celebrities on my show. Like, imagine what are the chances that you reach out to Mini Mathur on Instagram and ask her and she would say yes to you. What are the chances? For me, it's working, touch wood. I'm just so grateful. I'm getting more followers. I'm getting followers' loyalty. Like, people come back and ask me, when are you putting out your next video? The minute I put out the video, they watch it. Then they follow me. They don't unfollow very quickly. Very few people unfollow. So majority of my followers stick around. There is a loyalty. And all of this by spending zero. So how do you do content marketing? Like, if you just Google, there will be a lot of answers on how do you do content marketing, and they're all very vague, all very random, all very open-ended. So my goal with this presentation is to narrow it down and tell you specifically that I did 1, 2, 3, 4, and you do 1, 2, 3, 4, and you know what? You're going to be able to target a lot of people by spending nothing and just by marketing your content. Have your content work for you. Have your content get customers, clients, followers for you. Whoever it is that you're looking for, whoever your target audience is, your content will bring them in for you. So here, your content is the core piece and everything around manages itself, depending on the content that you put out. So how do you do content marketing? So before we dive into that, I really want you to take a screenshot or a picture of this slide, because it is going to help you so, so much. Or write these things down. The very first point is that your content has to be shareable. It has to be shareable. Otherwise, imagine like you're putting something out and no one's sharing it. So how is it going to reach more people, right? So you need it to be shareable. So whatever content you're producing ever in your life, remember, would you share something like this? If the answer is yes, go ahead.
Second, it has to be snackable. Most times, not always, but most times. Like, I cannot imagine that if I'm putting out a 1 hour episode, it is snackable. No. So what I do is I pick out 1 minute clips from it and I put it on Instagram because I know that everyone can watch. Snackable means it's very easy, easy to consume. So, you know, there are snacks lying in the kitchen, you pick them up and you eat them randomly. Same way, there's, you know, small pieces of content lying here and there, you tend to consume them. So your content has to be snackable. It has to be crisp. Like, it has to be very topical. Crisp means topical. It has to be on point. Like, last night, there was this thing about Amitabh Bachchan. He was around, you know, he was tested positive for COVID, right? And if you see Twitter, all the handles are using hashtag Amitabh Bachchan and tweeting unrelated things, like things that may not be related. They're tweeting that also about it. Why? Because they're riding on that topic, you know, they're using that hashtag to maximize their reach. So it has to be always crisp and it has to be topical. Another point is that it has to be channel specific. Now imagine that if I put out a 1 hour video episode on Twitter, do you think anybody is going to watch it? No, because Twitter is not the platform where you put out videos. Twitter is a platform where you put out small blogs, 140 characters or less, micro blogging site. So those 140 characters or less is your forte when it comes to Twitter. And imagine me putting out tweets on YouTube. How random would that be, right? So you have to understand the channel. Channel means social media platform. And then put out your content. Your content has to be specific to that channel. Next is tailored to taste. Now imagine somebody said here that they want to have a cat podcast. Now a cat podcaster is pushing me content for cat podcasts, but I'm not a cat lady, for example. Just giving an example. So do you think that'll work? No, because that content is not tailored to my taste. My taste is that I love dogs. So why is she sending me cat videos, right? But if she's sending me dog videos, do you think I will want to follow her? Absolutely. Because the content that she's putting out is tailored to my taste. So how do you tailor your content to your audience's taste? Is when you identify your audience and you identify what your audience likes. Like when we started this, I asked you, what is it that you're expecting? You told me you're expecting podcasting. You are expecting to learn a few things about marketing. So I knew that my focus has to be on these 2 points, right? So when I am understanding your expectations and delivering my content according to your expectations, does it not become a win-win for you and for me? It does, right? So that's what I mean by tailored to taste. And it has to be value adding. Like, you are sitting here on a Monday morning. You could be sleeping right now. You could be catching up on, you know, that Abhishek Bachchan series that's just come out on Netflix. Or you could be watching a movie. Or you could be, you know, just dancing, listening to video. You could be working out because you woke up late on a Sunday. You could be doing so many things right now, but you are here. You are giving me 2 hours on a Sunday. Even your teachers, right? They could be doing, you know, they could be cooking up an extravagant meal for their family because it's a Sunday lunch and throughout the week they're working, but they're also here. So now what is my responsibility? That I have to give you value for the 2 hours that you're investing with me, right? So always, always and always remember that your content has to be value adding. Now the key is, like, you will go crazy if you create different content pieces for different platforms. So that's not how it works. So the key to content marketing is picking up one content asset. Content asset is your core asset. Like, here in this case, for the purpose of this session, let's say our core content asset is our podcast. Is everybody clear? Does anybody have any doubt on what a core content asset is and why we are saying that our podcast is our core content asset? Imagine that episode. Imagine that video episode or that audio episode being the core asset, right? That's the center. And then we will build a lot of small, small content assets around it. So I'll take you through that journey right now. So now, like, let's say that I pick up Ankur Variko's episode from my podcast as my core asset, okay? And I want to do content marketing with this core asset, right? So what I'm essentially going to do is I'm going to repurpose this content asset. This is my core content asset, and my goal as a content marketer is to repurpose this content. Now, this is a 1 hour video conversation that I had with Ankur Variko. And now my goal is to make smaller content assets out of this video. It could be textual, it could be video, it could be audio. I will make smaller pieces from this content. I will repurpose it, recycle it. Like, imagine that we're wearing these clothes. After 2 months, maybe it will be a pocha for our house, right? We recycle things. We don't throw away things, right? So you don't just use one content asset for one purpose. You recycle it. You repurpose it, right? And you put it out on different social media platforms. Let's see how I do that for Behenpur. And then same way, you have to do it for your podcast. So what I did with this episode is that, one, if you see the first tweet, validation from Mr. Variko, please pinch me. Now, what I did is I took a screenshot of his comment. He's appreciating me in this comment on YouTube. So I took a screenshot of it and I put it out on Twitter. And I said that, you know, Mr. Ankur Variko has complimented me. So what this does for me is, one, I have some content to put out on Twitter related to that episode, right? Second, what I'm doing very smartly and very cleverly is that I'm building credibility for myself. When you think that Groupon CEO is appreciating Filoni, that means she's doing something right. There's something about her podcast that he, such a big person, is appreciating her, right? So very cleverly, I used this tweet to build credibility for myself. This is one way I used that the episode here. Second way I used it on Twitter is that what I did is I built a thread, a series of tweets of the things that I learned from him during our conversation. And I put it out that, you know, I asked him that, why did he say a yes to me? And he said, because I engage with his content very often. So he would notice me always, and he loved the reason why I'm doing the Behenpur, and he said yes to me. So that way I list out 9 or 10 learnings from that conversation as tweets. So very cleverly, what I did is I repurposed this episode into a series of tweets to work for me, to do all the marketing for me. And the first tweet, this one, validation from Mr. Variko, is seen by 1,000 people. I have 250 followers, but 1,000 people have seen this tweet and they've opened that comment and have read it. Imagine. So that is the reach. I may just have 250 followers, but still my tweet will reach so many people. One more example of repurposing the same episode. Now, what I did is, on Instagram, I cannot upload a 1 hour video. Maximum, I can upload a 10-minute video clip. So what I did is, I pick out 1 or 2 minute clips from that big video, and I put those 1-2 minute clips here in the first row, third video, third row, third video, last row, middle video. And everywhere else, what I've done is, failure is beautiful. This was said by Ankur Variko. So do you see what I'm doing here very cleverly? I'm cutting the video and putting smaller chunks of it on Instagram. Plus, I'm picking up words from there, making quotes and posters and putting it on Instagram and optimizing it for Instagram. Like, how brilliant is that? What I simply did is one content piece and I'm recycling it so many times for different platforms in different ways. But it's just one content piece, core content piece. So do you understand that how I'm making one piece work in so many different ways for me? Now for this one, I need you to give me ideas. Like, imagine I want to build a newsletter. How can I repurpose this episode for my newsletter? Quick answers in the chat box. If I want to email somebody, how can I use this content asset? Give me ideas. Can you think of some? Some of my little marketers. One way I think I can do it is that I can, failure is beautiful, right? Subject line. I love that. Himanshu is going to be a very good content marketer and is going to have amazing click-through rates. And I can email this video as a whole. I can make a blog of this episode and send the blog via email, right? So give me a yes if you're understanding the concept of repurposing the content. Give me a yes very quickly. All right. Okay. Another very important key to kind of, make content marketing work for you is to build a content calendar. I'm sharing with you my own content calendar for the month of June, which was last month. So I planned my days, like as a content marketer, you always work 1 month in advance. So this month I'm done shooting all my episodes for the month of July. I'm working for August and July. So you always work 1 month ahead of time. So you need to have a planner. It doesn't happen randomly. So for my August calendar, I know that 15th August is Independence Day. So I need to have a content piece around it. So in July itself, I will identify the key events that are there. I will identify the people that I want for, the month. And I will film and I will reach out to them and I will talk to them already in July. And I will plan my things. Because on 15th August morning, you cannot wake up and say, oh, today's 15th August, I need to put out a poster. Because by the time you put out the poster, it's old news. Because you know how quickly social media, the turnaround time is. Right now, Amitabh Bachchan is trending. In an hour, someone else may be trending. So you cannot afford to miss these trends, which is why you have to be very proactive. You have to work at least 1 month ahead of time. In the radio station that I used to work, my calendar used to be ready for 3 months, which means for August, let's take April for example. The content for April was ready and packed in January. The content of May was ready and packed, all scheduled to go in February. It has to be pre-planned. Always, always, and always. Otherwise, you will miss out. So it's very important to build your content calendar at least a month ahead in time. And another very important thing is storytelling. And this is the final point that I'm going to discuss with you. Now, storytelling is very important. Like, imagine you put out a series of random things. Nobody is going to be interested. But imagine you weaving everything into a story, like how I took you through who I am, what I'm doing, and how I'm helping you. I built a storyline around it, which is why you are sticking around with me right now. Same way, for anything and everything that you do, you always have to build a story and you have to be a storyteller. You have to connect the dots. So
You will be surprised to know that my most watched episodes are not the celebrities that come in. They are of common people who have done extraordinary things. I will tell you about Geetika. Geetika, for example, she got divorced and she was left on the road at 12:30 a.m. in the night with her 2.5-year-old daughter. And she rebuilt her life so amazingly well that last year she went to Harvard Business School in USA. Can you imagine going to Harvard Business School? I struggled to get admission in NMIMS, and she went to Harvard Business School with a 9-year-old daughter. And forget about the fees and how she managed doing that. So that's her story. A single mom was left on the street with a 2.5-year-old going to Harvard when her daughter turned 9. Same way, I want you to meet Karishma, whose episode is going to reach 2,000 views. She's a radio jockey in Dubai. She works with this radio station called City 1016. Every time Shah Rukh Khan is in Dubai, he makes sure he dances with Karishma. Forget about having a conversation. He makes sure he dances with Karishma. Her name is Karishma Fernandez. This was May 2017 when Karishma announced her pregnancy. She was 3 months pregnant. She already had 2 daughters. So she and her husband and her daughters put out this photo saying that they were expecting another baby. And a week after the announcement, her husband passed away. So she is this pregnant widow left with 2 kids in Dubai on her own. And let me tell you, Dubai is a very expensive city. Everybody told her that she is not going to be able to survive in Dubai. She is not going to be able to manage education of 3 kids, like 2 who are already there and the third who are on the way, which you can see in the picture. His name is Asya. He's not met his father ever. And imagine how Karishma is doing this. This is really today. She is so happy. She's living her life and she's doing well for herself. And her story is crossing 2,000 views very soon. So how does that work? It's the storytelling that matters. You have to be a storyteller. You have to tell stories. And only then your marketing work. Always try and build a storyline and communicate it with your audience. This was my final point, and I will share the tools with you very quickly. The tools that I use are MailChimp for email communications and Canva. You see the PPTs that I used? I did not use the regular PPT. I used the PPT available free of cost on Canva.com. Canva is going to help you. You know, please invest some time on using Canva.com. It's actually for any page. You can do so much with free services. And I'm building the PPT on the free for my podcast. Everything I do for free on Canva. I don't pay anything because I'm bootstrapping, so I don't. And I want you to pick up that. And one more very important tool that you must use is your imagination. Because these tools will take you from A to B, but your imagination will take you everywhere. Thank you so much for your time. Please share your feedback.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, is my voice better now? Okay, please share your feedback. And apart from that, I'm open to questions. Please share questions. Like, I want to give these 10 minutes for, and I want to address any questions that you guys may have that I may have missed. Yes, participants can post their quiz. Please share your questions or and I'm happy to address them. Like you have to quit right now. So what are the questions that you can think of? Like imagine that you are starting with your podcast. What is it that you think you struggle with? Or like, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I don't know how I'm going to do that. Kinjal, would you please guide them with the feedback forms?
Participants, kindly be patient. Feedback form link would be posted at the end of this session. We are still on the session.
Okay, great. Thank you, Angel. So I hope you have clarity on that, Ritu. And yes, please share your questions. I mean, this is your chance, right? Yes, please, Vineet.
Ma'am.
Yeah, participants. Oh.
Hello.
Right. Hi, Vineet.
Hi, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you for your sharing your knowledge about the podcasting and your experiences with that. What I think about podcasting is that, I think it shouldn't be to a limited kind of audience or limited kind of subject, because recently what I experienced I came across a video on Instagram. It was talking about the transgender. It was basically talking about
right.
the transgender.
I saw that, the joke piece, right? The joke piece video, is that the
yeah,
one
yeah,
that you're
yeah.
talking about?
Yes, right. That's
right.
The one. So I thought that through post podcast or through all these things, we can share things regarding the transgender or that community, because talking about that community is very taboo in our country. So I think
exactly.
that would be a good thing to tell people and address people regarding that community. And it is important in a country like us where there is taboo, because in other countries it is a bit like normal thing if people, some like gays or lesbian, just hang us around,
right.
but not in our
right.
country.
Right, absolutely. That's what I said. So when I asked you, what is it that you're passionate about, you can have a podcast where you want to help the community of Jyotis, Lunaks, and everybody. Like, you know, you can say that, you know, I want to stand up for their rights, and I'm going to have these conversations with them, like they had been, right? So
yeah,
then they did a wonderful thing by sharing the video bite with you. And you can have a podcast about it. It's your stage. And again, there's no limitation on your audience. It could be Indian, it could be global. There is no limitation on your choice of topics. It could be something that you are very passionate about. It could be, you know, anything that you really want to do something, and you have a podcast on it. That would be amazing.
Yeah.
So I don't understand what your question is, though.
I didn't have a question. I just had an opinion regarding that.
Okay, you just wanted to share. Okay, sure. That's a great idea, Vineet.
And secondly, I just need to share this thing, how I found Vishen Lakhani. I before that I didn't had any idea about him.
Mind Valley.
And I just googled him, and I was like, wow, he's created a company out of it. Just I was scrolling
right.
through Instagrams, and I got to know
right.
about a video. He was addressing a group of students. Maybe in a university, and he was talking about how to leave a job and get a startup. Like that, the 2-3 sentence of his caught my mind, and I was just, watched whole video of him. And through that, I got to know who is Vishen Lakhani and what he does, what he addresses. And there was one video, it was like 2 hours of video of his, and he has shared his experience through how he started from the failure to become an Malaysian entrepreneur right now.
Right.
So that right. was the thing. And I guess Jay Shetty was also. Jay Shetty was also with conversation with him.
If you have any questions, I would appreciate if you share any questions that you have more than sharing your ideas, because you know this time is limited and I wouldn't want to leave any question unanswered. So I really appreciate your opinion, but if there's anything specific that you want to ask me, please
no.
Thank you, Vinny.
Yeah, welcome.
And I encourage anybody else who's struggling with any question, please ask your questions. Like we have like about 5-7 minutes more. So whatever it is, it could be the smallest of things. But you know, instead of living in that doubt, just ask it out.
Ma'am, there is question on in chat box.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Sorry, my chat. Divya Rao, right? Okay. I found her podcast audio and video. The IT. Wow. She should not join the session, but she has two questions. Which is the best podcasting host to reach a larger audience? Okay. Podcast host would be SoundCloud. If you can pass on the answer to her, any tips monetization of the podcast and how to reach out to sponsors and brands. So the thing about monetization is that on YouTube she will have to sort of wait it out until she has 1,000 followers and 4,000 plus view hours of the content. So there is no other way to that. Once that has been done, YouTube will monetize it on its own. Like she has to opt in for monetization and it will happen on its own. That's one. On audio podcast platforms, if she wants to get sponsored, she really has to go the traditional way. She has to reach out to, you know, these podcasting platforms like IVM Podcasts, for example. She has to reach out to them, you know, cold call, cold email them. And it's the traditional way of reaching them. She has to go behind those to get that sponsored or purchased by them. Otherwise, she has to again wait out to get, you know, some good followers and good listening hours, and they'll automatically monetize. Even Anchor.fm has, you know, some monetization clauses. They take 30% and they give you 7% of the earnings. So that's pretty much clear on the app itself. What if we are not getting expected amount of a response on our podcast? What do you think or suggest us to do? Now, Swati, this, you know, content marketing is one, a lot of work. Second, you have to wait it out. Nothing that you do comes easily. Like we always have to wait it out. Like even when I started my podcast, I wasn't sure of the kind of response I would get. But, and you know, I'm still prepared that 6 months, I'm not going to make a single rupee out of my podcast. One, don't expect quick monetization. Two, you have to have a lot of content that you put out because everyone is different. What I see and what I like in a podcast, you may not like it so much. You may like something else about it, which I may be like, hey, this is not that great, you know, to be liked. And something that I like, you may have a different opinion about. So that is why it's very important for a podcaster to have a lot of content put out so that there is a bigger audience and your views increase. Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, there is a lot of audio breakage. Can you check
for audio breakage?
Yes, ma'am. Your audio is not clear.
Okay. Hello?
Yes,
is my video clear? And now is the audio clear?
Still there is a breakage.
Or is it still breakage? Okay. I will turn off my video. Maybe that helps.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it better now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Kinjal. Sorry for that. Okay. So yeah, how do you come up with good interviewing questions? That's a great question. Even I had this question when I started off. So someone told me that don't be too focused on the questions. Just start and listen to the person. When you listen to the person, you will know what to ask next. Imagine I told you my failure story. Then as an interviewer, your next question does not have to be that where have you worked? Your next question has to be, why do you think that you're a failure, Filoni? Right? So only when you listen to me, you will know that what to ask next. So you have to really listen to your guest. I hope that answers your question. Swati, I hope I have answered yours. Rashmi, how do we reach out to our target audience? Again, you reach out to your target audience by being very visible on the platform that you think you will find them. So, for example, I knew that I will find my target audience on Instagram. So I'm very active on Instagram. I'm putting out content there. I'm doing things there continuously. I'm putting out content. I'm putting out hashtags that are relevant. So, you know, my audience will be able to find me that way. Okay. Any more questions or any question that I have missed out, please repost. No, I don't think I have. Any more questions? What if someone don't share your podcast and content? What do you do then? Again, yeah, that's a great question. So, yeah. So initially, there will be very less people who will share your content, right? But once you kind of have a base, then people will start sharing more. Like when I started off, in the first month, no one was sharing. I used to put out amazing quotes and, you know, thoughts from famous people. I used to share these motivational clips and no one would share it. And then I would request people that, you know, please share if possible. So shareability is a very subjective thing. If I am able to relate with it, I will share it. If not, then I will not share it. So that one part is that it is subjective. Second is you have to again keep on doing a lot of trial and errors to figure out that, let's say that I put out a quote from Michelle Obama and I shared a quote from, let's say, Albert Einstein. And I see that a lot of people are resharing the quote from Michelle Obama. So then I know that Michelle Obama is working for my audience compared to Albert Einstein. So next time, what I will do is I will put out more of Michelle Obama quotes. So that's why it's a game of trial and errors. You have to try different pieces of content and figure out what works for you and for your audience. You may think that this may work and it may not work. And you may have not imagined that this story will take off and it will take off. You see, viral videos, a lot of times it's content that the makers never expected that, you know, it'll take off. It's a random video of father and daughter singing in the washroom and it took off. So, you know, it's very random. So it depends on your audience, but you have to keep on trying and experimenting. I hope I've answered your question, Raksha. How to make stories interesting and put it out there. Now, how to make stories interesting is something that you will be able to figure out. Why your audience persona is very important is because only when you know your audience, you will know what they will like and what they will enjoy. Like my audience will be very different from your audience, Swati. So I can tell you for my audience that this is the kind of story that they want to hear. But why am I able to say that with confidence is because I know my audience. So when you put some research into knowing your audience, you will automatically know what is it that they find interesting. So the part of building that audience persona is very important, that you have to figure out who your audience is and what do you think they like and what they don't like. Plus, again, like I said, you have to really experiment. You know, you say a story in one way and you say the same story in another way. And, you know, share it to different audiences and see what works better. This one or that one. That's a good way to test it. And you have a format that, you know, I put this out and this got more responses. I put that out and that got less responses. So I know this style is working on me. How do I reach out to platforms? For example, JioSaavn, if I wish to get my podcast heard through their platform. Okay. So if you want to reach out to JioSaavn, firstly, you need to have enough content on your name. Matlab, for them to be able to judge you or understand your podcast, you firstly do need to have a lot of episodes out there. Like at least I'm saying, have 12 episodes, and then you reach out to them, someone working at Saavn, you connect with them on LinkedIn, and you know, you reach out to them saying, you know, I have a podcast, I want to get it listed on Saavn. So Saavn takes only sponsorships. So your podcast is sponsored, like unfiltered, something is there. So that way you have to get their sponsorship. So they will guide you through the process, but you have to have some credible content to your name for them to be able to do that. Okay, we want to sponsor her. Oh, absolutely, Swati. That's a very good question. Voice modulating definitely helps, you know. Imagine if I was talking with very plain voice. No one would be interested, but there were points that I was really excited that, you know, it's very exciting and I'm going to take you through this journey. Or there were points where I was, you know, very firm and I had to be and ask you guys, do this, do that. So voice modulation plays a very important role, but it comes with time. You know, when you start off, you may not be great, but eventually you will get comfortable and it will come naturally. Also, there are tutorials on YouTube to learn how to modulate your voice. Any more questions? Kinjal, would you share the link with them if there are no more questions?
Participants, do you have any more questions? I think there are no more questions. So thank you, Kiloni,
thank
ma'am,
you for such a lovely session
and making our Sunday afternoon very informative and interactive. I would request, I would also like to thank management and Rima ma'am for giving us this opportunity. And I would request Sunil sir to give his valedictory speech.
Thank you, Kinjal, again. And thank you for being such a lovely audience, everyone. Please do not leave. I would love to hear your feedback on the session. So please drop your feedback and, you know,
Sunil sir, can you hear me?
Good afternoon. Hi Filoni. Hi again.
Hi.
Sunil sir proposes the vote of thanks, I would really, really like to, you know, express my gratitude towards Filoni. I know we have been planning this, since 3-4 months, and we actually wanted to have a workshop in college.
To be honest.
But somehow somehow it couldn't work out because of syllabus schedule and all, but I'm very happy that we are here right now in this webinar. So thank you very much. I also appreciate my students who have been very interactive today, and I'm very happy. I hope you all are interactive like this only. Absolutely. When we start with online lectures probably next month. So thank you so much. With this, I would really request Sunil sir, my colleague, to propose the vote of thanks. Over to you, Sunil sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Rima ma'am. Hello.
Sir.
Am I audible? Hello.
Yes, sir. You can continue.
Yes, you are.
Thank you. Okay. I, Sunil Yadav, would like to take this opportunity to propose vote of thanks on behalf of my department. I express my gratitude towards the principal, Dr. Srikant Saavn, CEO, Dr. Mala Kharkar, Chief Coordinator, Dr. B.M. Rai, and BMMC Coordinator, Ms. Rima Kordros. Special thanks to our resource person, Ms. Filoni Kanani, that she had took out her time from her busy schedule and delivered such an informative session. Last but not the least, To all our dear participants, thank you all for your participation. And I strongly believe you all have got few takeaways from this informative webinar. Thank you all. Stay home, stay safe, and do follow social distancing. Thank you all once again.
Yes. Thank you, Sunil, sir. And I would love and really appreciate one more favor from all of you guys. Please fill the feedback form so that I know where I can improve and what are the areas that work on and probably need a hopefully. Thank you so much for being here, taking the time. Being a lovely audience, and thank you again to Parker College, who's working on this Sunday morning, afternoon. Thank you.